Whoever said the pen is mightier than a sword? In a former life, I spent a lot of time behind the mesh of a fencing mask, each bout and every touch slowly pulling back a layer of myself. I was drawn by the primordial dance of fight or flight. I tasted it all, from the thrill of victory, and at the tender age of 14 when I fenced in my first junior world championships, to the bottomless pits of frustration as I scoured tournament after tournament looking for my alchemist philosopher's stone of immortal greatness. I was desperate to transform the raw ingredients of training, talents, and desires into something that would stand the test of time. Do you see your struggles to be heard, influential and effective in your organization, as duels? How often do you cross blades with opponents in your organization? Are you playing to win, or have you written your own unpublished special set of rules to govern your interactions? Over time, something curious struck me. When I lifted my mask, the struggle ceased.
The mask is an intriguing metaphor. As a competitor, I began to realize that when I took off my mask, the match was over. I could begin to see a person as a person and not as a competitor. In fact, over time, even my whole notions of competition changed. I gave up the myth that I was ever going to be the greatest. After all, there was always someone better than me. And in fact, doing my best, I began to think, was bringing out the best in others. That was the only way that I knew I could be at my best. Well, how can we apply this in organizations? Well, first of all, I think we all walk around with our masks, and many of us are ready to compete and enter into duels with one another, to have our viewpoints heard. Well, maybe in fact, if we could begin to see our responsibility as bringing out the best in others, and stop engaging in all of those duels and battles, then I feel that not only will others be able to perform well, but we'll be performing at our optimum.